Hey everyone, Daniel here from Twin Bytes with another tutorial for you. This time on working with the folder view in Windows and the image thumbnails. If you know how you see a thumbnail view for your photos, like here, and it makes it convenient so you know what the photo is rather than just going by the name of the photo. But have you ever had the case where you're opening up a folder and it's just not showing you the thumbnails? They're just coming up like this. Well, I'm going to explain how it's such a quick and easy fix here, coming right up. All right, so quickly, real quick shout out. Thank you to Hugh Barnsley for this question, and it prompted the making of this video. I'll link to him here. So the problem is quite simple here, and I'm going to show you the solution to it as well as some other things. So even though it's a quick answer that's faster than the introduction to this video, stick around because I'm going to show you a few other things that you might not know about with working with the folders. So let's have a look at my screen here. So when you're looking at the screen and you have a folder here, for example, I've got a folder for clips, and it's showing a list of clips. So I want to go into view here, large icons, medium, usually even large or extra large should show you the thumbnails, but instead we're seeing this view here, which is not very helpful at all. So the problem with this, if we go back to this other screen here, is we'll see it's a zip folder. It's not a regular folder. That's what the problem is. So the solution is we got to unzip it. So how do you unzip it? You're thinking you just double click on it and view it. There's a couple of ways of doing it. You could just right click on it and say extract all. But there's also, when you click on it, a folder appears up here that says extract, compress folder tools. If you click on that, then you'll see extract all. And it will prompt you the location of where it's going to unzip it to, and it'll put it in the same folder by default. So I'm going to uncheck to show the extracted files when complete, just so that we can see here that the folder is now created in that same location with the same name. So if I click on that folder and go into it, now I can actually see the thumbnails for that folder. It's as simple as that. You just need to unzip the folder. Now, there's a lot of options in here. Most people don't even look at them. You're just working with your files, opening them. So like all the other folders that you have within Windows, there's a lot of options in here. So there's some quick shortcuts up in the top where if you hover the mouse over, usually it will tell you, you know, you got your quick menu there to close, minimize, and so on. You've got a properties button, so whatever the folder is that you're highlighted on will give you the properties for that. And you can create a new folder inside of this folder right from there. And then this other little drop down menu gives you some more options where you can customize the quick access, adding the undo, redo, delete, rename, and a couple other things here to show the ribbon below. Or minimize the ribbon. So that is something as well that giving you a little bit extra space here. I've had people do this by accident, and then you click on it and you can see the options here, but if you are just looking at the folders, you might be thinking, well, where's all my options that were up here? They're gone. It's because this is set to minimize. So you could go back over here and uncheck that to minimize the ribbon, but you could also just do what you probably did in the first place, which accidentally minimized it, is just double click on it. And now as I'm clicking around on the different files or moving around, it's keeping that ribbon open so I can see all of the properties still. I've seen that happen many times and I've done it myself too. It just slip of the finger, you accidentally double click when you meant to single click. And maybe it's too much coffee, I don't know what it is, but somehow this kind of stuff can happen. And for the average person, if they don't know that that's a shortcut and what it's actually done, they just start freaking out when they double click on it by accident and think, oh crap, where's all the options gone to? Click once and it shows them, and click off and it disappears, or just double click on any one of these tabs and it will bring it back. Or go up to the menu here and you can minimize and uncheck the minimize. Even showing the, you know, changing the location of the ribbon, the ribbon's above these quick access things. So that just moves that around for you. And within each one of these tabs, Microsoft has tried to organize things in a way that makes sense. So your home screen is what you have by default. And that's what you use most of the time. When you're highlighting something, you've got the ability to copy and paste or cut and moving it or copying it somewhere else or deleting it. You know, renaming and making new folders. So those are all pretty common things as well. And under the sharing, depending on what other software you have installed, you may see some other things in here. And depending on the version of Windows, you may have some encryption here as well. There's some advanced security options. We're not going to go into too much detail in that. But under view, this is something to help you view your folders a little bit better. So we've got the thumbnail view, as we know. Captain Obvious, appropriate timing. Medium, list. You've got detail view, which sometimes if you want to have that, you can click on any one of these headings. So if you want it to sort it by the date or the type to see all of the same type together and the size, maybe to see which is the longest one. So whatever you click on, it'll sort it by that, and clicking it again changes it from ascending to descending order, and clicking again reverses it back again. One thing that I found that's a little bit annoying, like that fan, I should have turned off first. I'm gonna just turn that off. Okay, so one of the things that I found that's a little bit annoying, and you might find as well, and you wouldn't even know what to call it, is in group by. And it will group the folders and files by alphabet, or somehow it'll come up with some way. If you click on group by, you can choose, are you grouping it by the names, by the dates, by the type. So you can see here it'll group them that way, and then as they're grouped, you can still sort them by any one of these columns, but they're still categorized at the same time. So you'd be clicking around like crazy on these buttons or on the headings trying to sort it by one of these headings, and it's still having the groups. So you go to group by and select none. That takes out the grouping, and now it's simply sorted by whatever heading that you have that selected on. I think that's a big one. You can also choose sort by and choose the options from here. And there's other things here. You can add more columns for the folder that may not be showing. Depending on what you have in that folder, there'll be columns by default based on the type of files you have. For example, the length column. That only makes sense if it's a video or a music file. If they're just pictures, there is no length to a picture. So that folder or that column wouldn't even be there. you would have the hidden files option you can turn on and off. And for me, I usually seem to have that on because I can see things that might have gotten hidden, or even viruses that can go in your system. A lot of times they'll hide themselves so you won't even know that they're in there. So it can give you a little bit too much, and it can be overwhelming for most people. And you'll see ghost files of things that you're working on. So normally maybe you want to leave that off, but at least you know that's there. And there is an options button where you can go in here, change folder, and search options. And something else here, now I've already got this changed on mine, is by default when you open the file explorer, it goes to the quick access view. And for me, I like to see this PC view, and it gives you the hard drives that you have installed on the system, your documents, pictures, downloads, instead of quick access just showing you the last things you worked on. Well, I'm constantly working on different things, so I don't really need the last thing I worked on. I'm working on stuff right from the documents folder. And this now, as well, you might be, in the past we'd have to change it because it was annoying having each folder you click on, it would open in its own window, and then all of a sudden you've got dozens of folders open. So having it open in the same window, it saves on memory as well on your computer, so you're not having so many folders open, and really you just need that one that you're working on. You're just trying to drill down through the subfolder, so you might want to make sure that's on. And yeah, the quick access, if you're making use of that, to show recently used files in a quick access, you can even clear them out there so that you're not getting all the history, but you can work with the current recent files that you're working on and not having all the other crap. But if you have open file explorer to this PC, then the quick access thing may not even matter as much to you anyway. So that's in the folder options under options and change folder and search options. And because this is a video folder, there's video tools on here. If I have a picture highlighted, it says picture tools. So depending on what you click on, there may be other options appear up here. And I was going to go back to show you the zip folder again, because that's where we saw zip, but that reminded me, a quick way of going back is clicking on one of these. So you can see here, as you highlight the mouse over top of one of these, that basically tells you which one you're going to click on, and you can jump back to that specific folder. So if I highlight this zip folder, we have a compressed folders tools. So that is basically the quick short version of using the folders in Windows, and hopefully that helps you with your organizing of your files, videos, music, and so on. And if you guys have other questions, comments, suggestions for a new video, please put them down in the comments below or on the community tab. You can let me know any way you like, and give you a shout out like I do with all my suggestions. Greatly appreciate it, because you guys, without you, I wouldn't be making these videos. So thanks again. Hit that like button if you found this video helpful, and subscribe if you haven't already so that you'll be reminded every time we come out with a new video. All right, thanks again for watching, and we'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.